Aquatic plants are a beneficial and necessary part of Missouri ponds and lakes. Without them, most other organisms cannot survive. Ideally, 10 to 20% of a pond's bottom and surface should have aquatic plants. If more than 20% of the pond has aquatic plants, or if aquatic vegetation is interfering with some pond uses, mechanical, biological, or chemical control methods should be considered. Shading areas with large sheets of black plastic will kill virtually all aquatic plants under the sheet within 30 days. This method can be difficult, cumbersome, and requires daily monitoring. While pond dyes can darken the water, they generally are not as effective as other control methods. Gravel, sand, or clay may be used to blanket submerged plants. The aquatic plants that get covered will have a difficult time trying to grow through physical barriers such as gravel or sand. However, submerged plants will return to the treated area sooner or later. Some aquatic plants can be controlled by pulling, digging, cutting, and raking. Regardless of whichever approach you try, the process isn't particularly enjoyable and may involve intense physical labor. Drawdowns for controlling nuisance aquatic plants should begin in November, exposing and drying sediments for a minimum of 2 to 4 weeks to prolonged freezing through early March. However, both freezing and drying may be difficult to achieve in the typically unpredictable weather of a Missouri winter. The grass carp is a plant-eating member of the minnow family and can be effective in controlling many submerged plants. However, the fish can rapidly reduce or eliminate desirable aquatic plants, recycle their nutrients, and may lead to increased growth of the problem plants. Proper identification of aquatic plants is critical prior to applying herbicide. Different aquatic plants require different herbicides for control. Treat no more than 1/3 of the target aquatic plants at a 10-day to 2-week interval. A possible fish kill could result if too much of the target aquatic plant is treated at once. If these approaches do not work for your situation or to maintain long-term control, you might need to reduce nutrient inputs into your pond or lake. The final approach would be a total pond renovation. For more details about submerged plant control, check out this free aqua guide available on our website.